5-year-old Lena with heart disease came to Taiwan today from Vietnam with her family for medical treatment. At merely 5 years old, Lena was born with heart disease. Compared to children of the same age, she had relatively poor mobility and was often out of breath. She had several treatments in Vietnam, but had yet to see improvement. After several serious incidences, Lena's parents knew that they must look for a better and more effective treatment. After discussing with Dr. Nguyen, they decided to come to Taiwan. How does Taiwan, a country that occupies only 0.025% of the world, gain their trust? What advanced medical technology and advantage does Taiwan have? Every accident is like a tug of war with life. How do we judge the critical care or emergency care of a country or a hospital? ECMO capability is one of them. ECMO, ECMO. Also known as extracorporeal membrane oxygenation. ECMO is an extracorporeal cardiac and respiratory support system used to assist extracorporeal breathing and circulation for patients when most medical methods fail. It works by draining the blood from patients' veins to outside of the body and warming the oxygenated blood after gas exchange, then sending it back to the human body through veins or arteries in order to replace the functions of lungs or hearts. In 1972, ECMO was first adopted by Professor Robert H. Bartlett from Michigan State University. As the effects were not ideal and the complications were not alleviated, it did not become popular in the two decades afterwards. National Taiwan University Hospital completed the first ECMO surgery in Taiwan on August 11, 1994. Since then, the ECMO medical technology has made significant breakthroughs in Taiwan. This is Professor Chen Yixiang, doctor of NTUH Cardiovascular Center. Even better known is the fact that he pushed ECMO to be widely used in Taiwan 20 years ago, which saved many lives.
叶克膜在台大医院比较特殊是会比较出名是在急救方面的，我们发现这是一条不一样的路，因为急救情形大概都大家知道这个死亡率非常非常的高，然后超过5分钟10分钟以后存活率从一半或七成马上掉到10%，10%以下，急救时间如果超过60分钟活的机会不用叶克膜的 只有个位数字，但是你装了叶克膜多20%，这些病人他会活下来，表示这个是可行的。To
gain more time for patients, the ventricular auxiliary device with ECMO technology of NTUH is installed on Shen Hui Chen.
这样的叶克膜装置可以维持4个月、5个月更久的时间，可以让他有机会等到心脏。过来的时候，我女儿叫计程车送我过来了，所以我就会到那个窗户，每天都去看那个下面计程车排班。那我就期待说，我要坐其中一台计程车回家。
In 2003, NTUH published the first large-scale ECMO-assisted emergency paper in the world. The research result was published in well-known medical journals, including Lancet. It confirms the feasibility of adapting ECMO on CPR, therefore creating the term ECPR. Since then, when mentioning ECPR, the excellent performance of NTUH comes with it. Number of cases, survival rate, and academic achievement all lead the world.
叶克膜事实上并不是台湾独有的，只是我们在台湾我们把它更发扬光大。
Yeah, very quickly, right?
After arriving at the hospital, Lena underwent a series of examinations. To ensure the best time for treatment, and considering the hardship Lena's family endured, flying all the way from Vietnam, the hospital has arranged relatively intensive examinations. The results were not very assuring, and Lena's mother was very worried.Lena's father arrived just before the operation. He was so worried about his daughter, and his fatigue was showing from staying up all night. But he still pulled himself together to accompany Lena at her critical moment. Operating on wounds that are only a few centimeters in dimension with minimally invasive technology,Replacing human hands with special equipment. For doctors, dealing with complex heart diseases requires more practical experience compared to traditional surgery. In Asia, Taiwan has always been the pioneer.
传统来说，心脏的手术都是以所谓的正中胸骨切开的方式。所以，心脏外科的手术进到微创的时候，当铺路变小。当进入的障碍变高的时候，学习曲线上面相对来讲是困难的。
Vice President Guang Ming-chiu of Far Eastern Memorial Hospital leads the Cardiovascular Medical Center team to invest in minimally invasive heart surgery for 18 years. Treating patients with tenderness and a serious and cautious attitude for every operation.Including more than 3,000 coronary bypass surgeries, 2,100 heart valve surgeries, and 54 heart transplants. He is globally renowned for his minimally invasive heart surgery achievement. Among many of his medical stories, the most distinctive one is who we call Sister Tao.
Tao 姐是一个印象很深刻的一个个案，她是一个重度主动脉瓣膜狭窄的个案。所以心脏的血打不出去，心脏的负担很重，全身的血液供应又不足，他的心肺机能就会很快的下降。那陶姐需要做进一步的治疗，那进一步的治疗选择的就是台湾，由我帮他做所谓的微创的主动脉瓣膜置换手术。
他除了害怕动手术之外，他也有强调说他的伤口不要那么大。那时候我也觉得很，异想天开，因为。就我的认知，那个伤口是很大的，开心脏手术的伤口。然后我也就是经过一直跟他讲，然后可是因为他很信任我，所以他就说那好这样。然后真的很奇妙，就把他转介到那个邱医师的时候，哦，我真的是哇，很开心。然后邱医师就说他可以帮他动那个微创手术，就是那个微创手术很厉害的地方是他的伤口很小，所以他恢复很快。他好像出完院之后，他好像就恢复正常，而且他甚至体力比之前还好，所以他就很开心，就一直跟我们说他好了，然后他很强壮了这样。
Speaking of minimally invasive surgery, we have to mention the Da Vinci Minimally Invasive Surgery System.Surgeons utilize robotic arms to perform more delicate actions and execute precise resection, repair, and suture. Speaking of minimally invasive technology, Taiwan has achieved greater performance in terms of applicable range and cost effectiveness than Da Vinci.At this moment, Lena's operation is in progress. Her heartbeat per second is more than double the normal rate, which is a big load that may cause the heart to stop at any time. The surgery was performed in the cardiac catheterization room in cooperation with the monitoring room. The medical team is actively establishing a 3D model of Lena's heart to find out the cause of such a high heartbeat.The medical team is formed by cardiologists, nurses, and technicians. They are the internationally known VTGH arrhythmia team. Vice Superintendent Chen is also a globally renowned cardiac electrophysiology expert. His catheter ablation technique is top of the world.
我们换导管进去哈，导管先把整个心脏壁的所有的电力全部都收集起来，所以实际上也是一个大数据的概念。那这个电力的话，它整个就呈现在一个心脏的一个模型上面。所以你有哪一个地方有不正常的电力出来，你就要像雷达的东西，可以侦测到你这一支导管放到哪个地方去的，然后再给它放电去烧它这样子。
Her family outside is getting anxious. Lena is going to undergo a very delicate heart surgery. It requires advanced hardware and skilled staff with a cross-department cooperation. Unable to wait for Lena to come out of the operation room, Dr. Chen and Dr. Gwen immediately announced the good news to the family waiting outside.Knowing that Lena was finally rid of the threat of heart disease after many years, her family was happy and relieved. This cross-nation journey reignited the hope of five-year-old Lena's future once again. The heart is the key to life. For the past 15 years, heart disease has been the leading cause of death worldwide.More countries are investing significant research and manpower, hoping to reduce the fatality rate. Taiwan has been a leader of cardiology technology and research in the world.